I know that there's a lot of people out there who have mediocre children. And so for them to get the opportunity to have a snapshot of what it's like to raise a genius is probably pretty thrilling for them. My name is Miranda, and my son is an artistic genius.
What's it like raising an art prodigy?
I haven't had a haircut or gone to the dentist in the 10 years since he's been born. But that's the mark of a devoted mother. Anything less would be neglect. Every time he creates something, we really want to encourage him. So he gets a certificate of participation. You know, the most talented person to ever live. Van Gogh reincarnated. Genius little boy. We have a stack of about 15 here. He's earned all of these just this week.
What are some of your tips to moms who want to create a prodigy?
Well, I mean, the first thing that I would take into account is either your kid is a genius or he isn't. No television, only eats organic, non-processed foods, drinks a lot of green juice, make sure that you have a hot tub so he can work out his feelings, especially when he's like 2, 3, 4, those kind of tantrumy years. We call it self-expression around here. My son has never had a preservative in his life. He often enjoys fresh organic kale as a snack. He's never been exposed to television, any sort of media, or video games. All he enjoys is creativity.
Sounds like you're getting a lot of interest in your son's artwork.
As a matter of fact, I am. Oh, one sec, I'm sorry, this is so awkward. Hello? You're interested in pumpkins make mommy happy. Sure, yeah, you're not the only one.
Does he do any sports or anything, or is this really his life?
Yeah, I mean, I think all artists and genius really suffer for their work. You know, did Einstein ever put the pencil down when he was making equations? I don't think so.
What are some of the other titles for the artwork that you have over here?
Well, this one in particular, I think we can all agree, is just downright poetic. It's called I Found a Dead Bird. The other one is Stephen Took My Scooter. This was a commission piece. I asked him to make it. I think we all have a Stephen in our lives that is taking our scooter, and we also have Kitty. Kitty is, you know, very early Picasso-inspired piece.
You're wearing gloves. Is there a reason for that?
The reason for that is because I don't want to compromise the integrity. We have a whole collection here, and it's very important that no oils or lotions, perfumes are exposed.
Has anyone ever told you that your kid's art's really not good?
I have had a few people that have offered some unsolicited criticism in the past, but you know, hey, haters gonna hate, you know? Thank you.